the custom wrestlers.
Nah, they changed it. Same thing with NBA 2K. They changed it. So it's like now you can't. So if I like if I make somebody, I can't get his original music from online. Because like, you know, like this dude right here, Dragon Lee, he's from New Japan Wrestling. I can't get his music. Hold on, let me put the volume on now. Hold on. But they got all the original people that's in here, they got all their music in there. These dudes got the entrances, man. That's the only thing about it. The original guys got the entrances. They got the throwback Triple H.
The game, Triple H. Great kid, Shawn Michaels! The Undertaker! The Rock!
Yeah, that match is gonna be dope. That Seth Rollins, that Finn Balor. Bobby Lashley won it on Raw. Yeah, Bobby Lashley won the belt on Raw.
Goldberg!
That shit, man. So it's a triple threat between them two and Bobby Lashley. You know, they got into a fight. Bobby Lashley took advantage. And beat the niggas up, took that belt. think they ain't signed a match yet for Bobby Lashley though. I think he's just gonna be in the Rumble though. I didn't see a 1-on-1 match. I think the 29th. I think it's next week. Not this Sunday, but the Sunday after that. It's coming up. And they got 11 spots. They got 18 open spots. So 18 mystery people gonna show up. This nigga friggin'
Mankind!
Oh, that's a dope match. That's a dope match. That's a dope match. Elias is not funny. Turn volume to 30. Bobby Lashley. Yeah, that's the best thing they can do with him, man, is turn him bad. Because he was disgusting as a good guy. Daddy.
actually, this is such a bad thing. And remember, when he gets on the roll, he's nearly impossible to stop. You are absolutely right, Cole. So I expect to see his opposition do everything possible to prevent momentum from swinging too much to his side.
Georgia, weighing in at 270 pounds, Goldberg.
Guys, you gotta respect Goldberg, especially given how hard he works to be a hero to kids.
Yeah, he's definitely somebody you can feel good about your kids looking up to.
Guys look more than ready to start this match.
So is this crowd, Michael, and justifiably so. This one's gonna be simply amazing.
Calico.
Great to have you with us, folks. As usual, we're coming to you live alongside the best fans in sports entertainment. You'd absolutely be insane to change the channel, so don't even think about it. And we're starting this card off with some fireworks. Let's do this. Singles action on tap right now. The match we have next is going to be awesome. Stay where you are. We have one of the best talents on the roster to date against an imposing adversary. I can't wait.
156 pounds, Flash Morgan Webster.
Big time singles matches on deck here, and Byron, what should we expect to see here tonight?
Well, given the shape these superstars appear to be in here tonight, I fully expect to see one of the most competitive matches we've seen in a very long time.
Well, he definitely looks ready for what's ahead of him here tonight, that's for sure.
I agree with that, Michael. In fact, I don't remember the last...
And his opponent, from Washington, weighing in at 160 pounds, Leo Ross.
Singles action on its way, and it sounds like this arena is more than ready to kick this one off.
So is social media, Michael. The opening bell hasn't even rung, and yet both these superstars are already trending.
Here we go. Things are about to heat up. Oh, man, still not officially underway.
Well, official or unofficial, we're rolling here.
A superstar gets a certain feeling when he knows there's a strong possibility he may exit the match in a completely different condition than he entered. That's not exactly a comforting thought when it's your career.
And it looks to me like this entire arena is on its feet, and understandably so.
Uh-oh, he's in trouble here.
I don't think he should get up.
We may be looking at a powerbomb here.
That's exactly what it looks like to me, Cole.
That landed perfectly. He clearly has confidence in that move. And it's a big-time drop kick. And he hits with a diving assault. He's got to be dizzy after that. Back now inside the ring. Looking like himself here. Quick pin attempt here. He lands a jarring forearm. A brutal breaker. Just making his presence felt there. Inflicted with a snapmare. Can't wake up from that one. That move at this juncture of the match makes the intention unmistakable to belittle. Reverses that one. And he goes for the pin.
Turn volume to four.
Looks like he's starting to tire. You have to wonder if he could recover from this, guys.
The amount of punishment he's absorbed in this match is absolutely insane. A lesser man would have given up and walked away by now.
Yeah, he's clearly not on the right side of this match right now, which is a little surprising to me.
Looks like a power bomb coming up. There may be no escaping this one, Cole. And he goes down hard.
In the cage. In the cage now. In the cage. No, in the cage. Stop it now.
This is exactly how he drew this one up. Oh man, what a hit.
Knocked right off the apron.
Flips the script on him there. And he looks helpless after that enziguri. He's playing with him now.
He doesn't look too eager to get up, and I don't blame him.
Just gliding through the air on that moonsault. Six. Running out of time here.
Oh, come on, get in there.
Still trying to get back to his feet here.
Eight. He's clearly in a bad way right now.
And he finally gets back into the ring.
There is no way he was going to get counted out there, Michael.
That's how you make an impact. Shoulders down. Is it enough?
Oh, boy. He is rolling.
This could end it in a hurry.
He's back in control here.
There's almost no rebounding from a strike like that.
To the outside now.
Perhaps looking to gather his thoughts.
Pays for that one.
It's a matter of time now before this superstar goes for the finisher. And when that happens, you can bet this one's over.
Oh, and he hits a magnificent Hurricanrana. He doesn't appear to be in a hurry to get up here.
I just don't think he has it in him anymore.
Doesn't show any signs of getting up here, guys.
No, he's taking one heck of a beating, Michael.
He's in a tough spot here, Corey.
And if he doesn't get up, it's going to get a lot.
Look at that. The frog splash. This one is in the books.
But he's running on fumes here. Does he have enough left in him to capitalize?
He's taking a long time. Time to get up, guys.
Perhaps playing a little possum here, Cole.
And he just found out that's not the place you want to be. He knows he's in trouble.
You better stay right where he is.
I don't think there's any coming back from this type of assault. Will this be it? And Byron, he's still down after that one.
Yeah, that did some big time damage, Michael.
What's going to happen now? Very impressive senton. This could do it. This has been a battle.
He can't take much more.
And another one. Got the reversal. Late. strikes, taken out by the Russian leg sweep. He could pin his opponent right here. Oh, this is dangerous right here. Oh, and he's still down, Byron.
Things definitely aren't looking very good for him right now.
Incoming. That one fails to connect.
Great idea by him. Too bad it was awfully executed, though.
It could be over here. He's pressing all the right buttons down.
Ain't no stopping him now.
Incredible. This has to be it.
Just when you thought he had nothing left.
The way I see it, this might be a good time for the finisher.
He gets him with a reversal. He's focusing on the face now. There's the cover. Can he do it? A sickening thud as he lands. Shoulders down. This could be it. Going all the way up. He's looking at it. Frog splash. This should do it right there.
Given their performances tonight, it's too bad one of these superstars has to walk out of here on the losing end.
His leaping skills on display here. Perhaps thinking about what to do next here.
Well, better not think too long, though.
That'll change his posture in a hurry. Can he score the pin? Both these superstars appear to be operating on fumes here, guys.
Looks like both these superstars have found that little extra something to keep themselves going here tonight.
How's that for ferocious? It's like someone hit the repeat button for this move. He's calling for it.
He's teetering on the edge here. He's close to being done here.
There it is, the DDT.
Here's his moment, Michael.
He's looking for the win.
I don't know, guys. I really thought we would have seen the finisher already.
No, he reverses it. There's the pin. Can his opponent kick out? And we're back to this form of attack. Oh, you can't take many more shots to the face like that. I don't like the look in his eye here, folks. Showing very few signs of life here.
Yeah, there's no way.
Look at this. Imploding 450.
But I don't know how much gas he has left, guys.
There's the pinfall and the victory.
Here is your winner, Flash Morgan Webster.
What a grueling match. It looked like anybody's match there toward the end.
And talk about displaying a never-say-die attitude. It was as if winning was the only option here tonight.
And it'll be interesting to see the ripple effects this win has in the weeks to come. Now, don't go anywhere. We have a classic coming up.
We have a real fan favorite versus a formidable opponent.
What's going
Making
on here?
His way to the ring from Cardiff, Wales, weighing in.
Oh, the referee needs to get control of this.
Yeah, that didn't take long.
It's safe to say he underwent special training to put on this kind of aerial display. With the missile drop kick. His astonishing acrobatics coming through here. He connected on that one. That's how an aerialist damages an opponent. A textbook maneuver there.
Bates looking a little shaken here.
To be expected, though. It's not like he's in there with a slouch, guys.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves, Cole. This is just a little bump in the road for him here. Nothing to worry about.
Look at him move. What acrobatics. Singles action is underway, and in this one, I wouldn't attempt to predict what's going to happen. I'd just be ready for anything. Sometimes that's all you can do.
And man, I never get tired of watching these guys compete.
You guys both make great points, and right now it seems to me like Berman is ready for what will likely be an amazing match. He's got him now. Fighting for survival. And he escapes the submission.
And good thing, that could have been disastrous.
Man, that got him good. He landed a perfectly placed strike. That send a message to your adversary, all right.
He's starting to stagger a bit.
Well, these two guys, we all knew this was going to be an all-out battle.
He just has to make sure this doesn't get too out of hand for him. Sometimes, momentum has a way of permanently swinging one way. That's what he wants to avoid here.
He's lining him up.
Stay down, man.
The point of that elbow delivers. so fast.
A move like that is completely unnecessary, unless you want to degrade your opposition, of course.
Bates is definitely fading a little bit here.
He doesn't want to absorb much more punishment if he wants to win this match.
This match is trending in a bad direction for him right now, guys. He's going to want to make some changes if he wants to stay in it.
Don't write him off just yet, guys. What I see, these guys are pretty evenly matched at this point.
And some trouble here now for Bates.
He might just have nothing left to give, guys.
This could do it. Oh, somehow!
I am in shock. What's it gonna take to keep this guy down?
Plenty of force behind that strike. Oh, wow. Takes him down hard.
You gotta love that kind of aggression. Yeah, if he hits this, the match is over.
He's not looking good here, Byron.
No, he's got to get up, and he's got to get up now.
So damaging. Byron, he may be down for good.
That wouldn't surprise me at all, not after the beating he's taken.
This is simply amazing leaping ability. He wants no part of the outside. No, reverses it. Well, man, he's going off here. I don't know if this is by design or if he just lost his mind. Oh, he's able to reverse it. Missed by a large margin on that one.
Wow, he's better than that.
Showing off his vertical with that drop kick.
Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy.
He's in trouble.
He's almost got him.
Whoa, did you see what he just did? Incredible.
He's going for it all. He doesn't appear to be in a hurry to get up here.
I just don't think he has it in him anymore.
Incredible! Shoulders down, this could be it. He got all of that in Enziguri. Oh no, he's taken down.
You know, I don't think he has much left.
Here it comes. He's got him.
If he sticks this, he is done.
He's really putting his athleticism on display here. He may get the three count right there. Saw that one coming. He's fighting back here.
I expected nothing less, Cole.
On, he's one step ahead on that one.
He's in a little bit of trouble now. I'm not sure how much more he has to give.
The amount of punishment he's absorbed in this match is absolutely insane. A lesser man would have given up and walked away by now.
Guys, one of my favorite things about him is how much pride he has in his game. And up until now, he's had plenty to be proud about.
If this superstar can just land the finisher here, this match is all but over.
Who knows what's gonna happen? This match could go anywhere.
This might be it.
Reverses it. He's docking his opponent from the top turnbuckle. He's not getting...
Look out!
Here he goes. He's looking for the win. Against all odds, he's got the victory.
Here is your winner, Man Drew.
Now that's earning a well-fought victory.
When you get a one-on-one match like that, you hate to see one of them come up short. But that's just the harsh reality of it.
It'll be interesting to see the fallout following this big singles win here tonight.
To know who's going to come back and who's gone for good, we'll take a look at who's been confirmed to make it. During Endgame, and some of these callbacks may just surprise you. As we all know, the end of Avengers Infinity War had us saying goodbye to many of its enormous cast. While we lost many heroes during the decimation, there were some who passed away outside of that incident, and their fates are much more up in the air. Undoing Thanos' wish to wipe out half of all life in the universe is one thing, but what about the death of Gamora, who was thrown off a cliff before Thanos even acquired all of the Infinity Stones, or Loki and Heimdall, who both perished on a spaceship along with many of their fellow Asgardians? Because of this, who's going to show up in Avengers Endgame is a tantalizing mystery, and what else fans should... Yeah. Who's going to be coming back from Infinity War or from any of the other movies taking place in the MCU? Well, the IMDb page for Avengers Endgame has been updated, and there are some surprising entries to the cast list. Not only do some surprising faces pop up, but some familiar names are still missing, much to the dismay of many fans. In addition to its incredible visuals and the appearance of the Time Stone, Doctor Strange also contains a poignant moment which ranks among the most touching in the history of the MCU. The Ancient One, portrayed by actress Tilda Swinton, was responsible for teaching Doctor Strange about magic and was known for being a tough, fair, and surprisingly patient mentor. But later on in the movie, we learn that she managed to extend her life so long due to her connection to the insidious Dark Dimension. While the Ancient One felt the ends justified the means, others disagreed. During battle, the Ancient One was mortally wounded, but used her astral form to buy herself a little more time while she chatted with Doctor Strange. She revealed that, despite being able to see into multiple futures, she had never been able to see past the moment of her own demise. We rarely say this about characters in the MCU, but it definitely seems safe to say that the Ancient One left us for good at the end of Doctor Strange. This explains why fans were so surprised to see Tilda Swinton's name appear on the list of actors set to appear in Avengers Endgame. In addition, Mark Ruffalo, who plays the Hulk, mentioned during an interview that he enjoyed working with Tilda Swinton on a recent project. Since the Hulk wasn't in Doctor Strange and the Ancient One wasn't in Infinity War, many people had predicted this comment meant the Ancient One would be coming back for Endgame. But surely, the Ancient One can't come back from the dead, so is this further confirmation that time travel will be involved somehow? The Battle of New York was a momentous moment in the MCU, and we've seen some set photos which confirm that our heroes will be revisiting the site of this famous fight at some point during Endgame. Because we've seen pictures of an older-looking Tony Stark, many believe this confirms that our heroes will actually be traveling back in time instead of just reminiscing about a previous battle. Not only was this battle a significant, stake-raising, history-changing, world-altering one, but it represents a time when there were three Infinity Stones in close proximity to one another on Earth. The Space Stone, or the Tesseract, was in possession of Howard Stark, Tony's father, following the events of Captain America: The First Avenger. After the Avengers, Thor takes it back to Asgard, but during the battle, it's located at Stark Towers. Loki himself is in possession of the second Infinity Stone, the Mind Stone, which he uses in his scepter. Thanos gave it to him and ordered him to retrieve the Space Stone, but obviously that didn't quite go according to plan. And although we didn't realize it at the time, there was also a third Infinity Stone which could be readily accessed during this battle. During Doctor Strange, we learned the Ancient One possessed the Time Stone, which is being kept inside the artifact known as the Eye of Agamotto. We also learned about the New York Sanctum, one of the three Sanctum Sanctorums in the world. The Sanctum itself contains many magical artifacts, but it also allows easy access to where the Time Stone was being held. If our heroes do end up going back to the Battle of New York and they're looking for Infinity Stones, it's entirely possible that they visit the New York Sanctum during this journey. And at that moment in history, the Sanctum and the Time Stone were under the protection of the Ancient One, which would explain Tilda Swinton's appearance in Endgame. At the very least, three surviving members of the Avengers know where the New York Sanctum is. Doctor Strange brought Thor there for a brief chat about Loki during Thor Ragnarok, and Bruce Banner and Tony Stark visited during Infinity War. The Battle of New York could mean recovering half of the Infinity Stones in one fell swoop, considering she had seen so much during her exceptionally long life, but is unable to see past her own death. It would be interesting to see if the Ancient One expected our heroes to show up or not. Taking the Sorcerer Supreme by surprise seems like a really terrible idea, so hopefully she got a mystical heads up to expect them. Although we're very excited at the prospect of seeing the Ancient One back in action in the MCU, she isn't the only character listed as making an appearance. In fact, although we saw her take her last breath during Doctor Strange, she's actually the least surprising person on the cast list who didn't appear during Infinity War. Much more surprising was the name Frank Grillo, who portrays the character Brock Ruffalo, better known as Crossbones. This is another character we saw meet his end in the MCU, so it's hard to imagine how he could be showing up without the addition of time travel. Crossbones was one of the agents of Hydra operating within S.H.I.E.L.D., which we learned during Captain America: The Winter Soldier. He later attempted to assassinate Captain America, but ended up with some disfiguring facial scars for all of his trouble. During Captain America: Civil War, we learned Crossbones was the one who attempted to kill Captain America using an explosion, which Wanda Maximoff was forced to deflect using her powers. This caused the deaths of some innocent people, which then launched the Sokovia Accords and kicked off the Civil War portion of the film. While Crossbones isn't someone we might immediately think of when it comes to classic MCU villains, he did have a pretty important role in the history of the MCU. Sure, it's a particularly terrible part of its history, but it's history nonetheless. When we learned Frank Grillo would be reprising his role of Crossbones during Endgame, many comic book fans were excited about the prospect of the character being done justice on the big screen. Huh? So with that, we hate to disappoint, but we have to announce that Crossbones isn't really coming back in a true sense. Grillo has confirmed that he's going to be making an appearance during Endgame, but assures fans it's simply part of a flashback. Getting a direct answer from anyone involved in Endgame is pretty shocking, but at least we know what's going on. He even added not to expect him in any other Marvel movies because he's getting too old for that sort of thing. As to what the movie could be flashing back to, it could be any number of important MCU moments. After all, Crossbones is responsible in no small part for kicking off the Sokovia Accords and the resulting fallout among the Avengers. He was also one of the Hydra operatives working within S.H.I.E.L.D., another major plot point with far-reaching ramifications for the MCU. It will no doubt be interesting to see which of Crossbones' various evil deeds is going to be worth watching back to during Endgame. Now let's talk about the most unexpected addition to the Endgame cast so far, Harley Keener. To answer your next question, which we're sure is who? Harley Keener is that precocious little boy with a sad backstory who helped out Tony Stark during Iron Man 3. He was played by actor Ty Simpkins and was the first kid in the MCU to have a major role in a movie. When Tony needed to do some repairs to his Iron Man armor, he ended up in Harley's garage. Everyone makes a big deal about Tony Stark's relationship with Peter Parker, but before Spidey came along, there was Harley. He and Tony had a connection, according to Harley, and they both managed to help each other out of some difficult spots over the course of the movie, despite their differences in age and income. At the end of Iron Man 3, we saw that Tony had tricked out Harley's garage with some top-notch computer and robotics equipment, but that was all the way back in 2013, and most people never expected to see Harley come back, especially not in a massively significant movie like Endgame. With adult actors, it's easier to hide the passage of time, but considering how young Harley was during Iron Man 3, we have to think we're going to see a present-day Harley and not a flashback of him as a little kid years ago. We aren't saying that we disliked Harley's character, but many fans left the theater wondering what the point was of having Iron Man adopt a temporary, adorable little sidekick. Other than talking him down from his anxiety attack, Harley could have been omitted from the movie without changing it very much. Still, their relationship was sweet and perhaps helped to humanize Tony a little bit more. Many fans believe some of our favorite characters... make it through Endgame, and Tony is a popular pick for someone who might find themselves dead for good. Robert Downey Jr. has been in the MCU since it began, and many wonder if it's simply for logistical reasons that the character won't be used anymore. Story-wise, there are now other brilliant minds with access to advanced technology in the MCU, so his character wouldn't leave as much of a void at this point if he were to be killed off. If Tony does end up passing away during Endgame, seeing a more grown-up Harley at his funeral would definitely serve to make the moment more emotional. This touching cameo seems pretty likely, but some fans believe that Harley will have a much bigger part to play. If Tony Stark doesn't end up making it past the Endgame, is it possible we'll get a new Iron Man? During Iron Man 3, we saw a young Harley who was already adept at creating interesting gadgets, and since then, he's had tons of advanced technology at his disposal. We're guessing he hasn't been spending the time since Iron Man 3 and is just using those computers Tony gave him to play Fortnite instead. There's even a comic book precedent for a younger version of Iron Man called Iron Lad. In the comics, a teenager named Nathaniel Richards has trouble getting in touch with Tony, so he decides to build his own Iron Man suit. Sure, we know that Harley isn't the same as Nathaniel, but Marvel Studios isn't exactly known for sticking strictly to the comic books. We know it may not exactly count as surprising, but we think you should know that all of the heroes who perished during the decimation are slated to come back during Endgame. Of course, this doesn't mean they'll all necessarily survive, but it does mean that we'll get to see them on the big screen for a little bit longer. While who's going to show up during Endgame is a big deal, so is who isn't going to be making an appearance, at least not that we know of at this point in time. Lots of characters perished during Infinity War, whether as a result of the decimation itself or due to the battles fought to obtain or protect the Infinity Stones. Fans have been wondering if those characters who died outside of the decimation will be able to find their way back to the MCU, just like those who died from Thanos' snap are supposed to. While most people aren't exactly staying up at night wondering if the members of the Black Order are going to be okay, there are three characters everyone seems to be concerned about: Heimdall, Loki, and Gamora. It just so happens that none of the actors who portray them are confirmed to be appearing in Endgame. Of course, this could just be Marvel Studios messing with us and waiting to confirm all these characters until closer to the release date. After all, withholding information to build anticipation is kind of their thing, but there's still the very real possibility that we've seen some of these great characters for the very last time in the MCU. Now that we've given you all the confirmed information that we have, what do you think is going to happen during Endgame? What other characters do you expect to see show up? Let us know what you think in the comments section below. And don't forget to subscribe to CBR for more MCU content. Thanks for watching.
The Dyson Cypher and V-10s are most advanced shortly back into the world. Debris is forced into the bin by 14 cyclones. After all that extra dirt and picked up, we've made the bin bigger. The cord-free Dyson Cyclone V10, engineered for better cleaning performance.
Since introducing the shared cinematic universe, the MCU has filled up with Marvel characters. In Infinity War, there were 76 characters on screen at one time or another. 76! And that's not even everyone. Believe it or not, even with that many characters, not everyone has met. And with new characters on the way, there's even more team-ups coming. Here are some of the ones that we're looking forward to. Shuri and Tony Stark. While Black Panther was a runaway hit this year, there were more than a few characters that populated Wakanda who managed to steal the show. M'Baku went from...
My name's Michael Berman. I am super excited today for what is not only an enormous Easter egg for Avengers Endgame and Captain Marvel, but rather the whole MCU going forward. I'm going to break down what we found and contextualize it for you guys. First, if you could hit the subscribe button, we're giving away 2 PlayStation 4 Pros, as well as a whole slew of other Marvel stuff. All you have to do, hit the subscribe button, leave a like and a comment on this video, and hit the notification bell if you want. Stick around to the end of the video. I'm going to get into all the giveaway stuff again, and tomorrow we will be announcing the winner of 150,000 subscriber PlayStation 4 Pro. Now, as I've stated in the past, sometimes the Easter egg is right in front of you, and you don't know it because you don't know what you're looking for. And quietly last week, Mashable.com confirmed that the Tesseract would be making an appearance in Captain Marvel. This is obviously a big deal, as the Tesseract contains the Space Stone, and one of the Infinity Stones making an appearance in the movie is not a light thing, although it didn't specify in what capacity, and how long, and if it was a major player. Just said it would be making an appearance, which implies that it's just a cameo, perhaps in a backseat. However, this is seriously not an Easter egg that they would be willing to throw in a trailer, right? Surely they'd make us wait for the movie to see the Tesseract. So this is a screenshot directly from the brand new trailer that we just got. And I'm going to go ahead and loop the clip for you up just past the end. It's only on screen for a couple of frames, literally for less than 5 frames. So you have to go quick, and I'm just going to keep looping this. But you can clearly see it is in the sand there. Now, we had tons of other shots of it, actually, in the previous trailers, but we didn't have the confirmation from Mashable. And we also didn't know that that's what we were looking at. And they did a good job to obscure the squareness of the Tesseract. But now knowing that we've seen this, let's go ahead and look at some of the other screenshots from the previous trailers quickly. You can see in these two shots, this is the first frame that this one's on. Then it condenses a bit right here. You can see this is obviously a square-shaped object. And then right here, once you get to the last of this, take a good look at the shape of this. An elongated square. Alright, so this is definitely the Tesseract. So moving forward into Avengers Endgame, now Captain Marvel will be well-versed in what the Infinity Stones are and have intimate knowledge of it. But more importantly, going forward in the MCU, this all stems back to a quick retcon that Marvel Studios decided to do via an art book in reference to Scarlet Witch's enhancement. Speaking of the Mind Stone, in which saying the Mind Stone unlocked, rather, latent abilities in her. So it wasn't the Mind Stone that just enhanced her, but perhaps unlocked a latent ability in her. And a lot of people believe this is them setting up the ability of the Infinity Stones to alter mankind into mutants. Well, if that's the truth, then think about the implication of having Captain Marvel's latent ability unlocked by this the Tesseract. Now, I think there's a lot of time jumping, no pun intended, going on in the Captain Marvel trailer. And somehow we think of this as being more in the middle of the movie after she's already been to space. But let's back up a bit. We know when she comes back to Earth, she's already got the photon power. We also know from the trailer that when she's being trained by Jude Law's character, never that will be. Guys, what if it's Non-Log and Captain Marvel? Mind-blowing? I'm not even going to do a video on it. But still, we know that she has the ability to creep. So what if the Infinity Stone use her with this power? That's what almost kills her. They scoop her up in an attempt to get the Infinity Stone, they being either the Skrulls, super intelligence, or the Krees. They save her life. And in doing so, also wipe her memory, but she has that power already. Now this fits directly into the retcon that the Scarlet Witch Mind Stone has already set up. And I think the greater implication back to Avengers Endgame is if there is some major Infinity Stone event that brings everybody back. That is a lot of Infinity Stone power on a lot of people at once. Perhaps that's what unlocks and sets up mutants in the MCU going forward. And how coincidental that would be, and perfect it would be for the MCU Phase 4, considering we're about to get all the mutants back. But guys, let me know what you think in the comments. Is this the Tesseract? If it's not the Tesseract, feel free to let me know in the comments what small, squarish, blue-green object this could possibly be. And if you believe it's a Tesseract, do you follow me and think it's some sort of unsnap, maybe the key to unlocking the latent ability across humankind. Quickly, let's get into the giveaway stuff before it's go. Okay, we're giving away two PlayStation 4 Pros. We're also announcing the winner of the 150k subscriber PlayStation 4 Pro tomorrow. That's tomorrow, Friday, the 18th of January. It'll be at the end of the video, so we're giving away two more PlayStation 4 Pros, as well as this also limited edition Marvel Trendsetters limited plaque containing 10 original film sets from the first Avengers movie. These things are impossible to find. From the Marvel Studios store, Universal Studios. If you want to be on any of this, hit the subscribe button, leave a like and a comment on this video. Then hit the notification bell because the more you like, if you like and comment on, the better chance you have of winning. And make sure to tune in to tomorrow's video for the winner. And then hit the subscribe button. My name is Michael Rubin. This is everything always. Thanks for checking out the channel. Stick around and have a good day. We'll see you.
support.
Dr. Orlo, after verdicts, from the French ship wrecked 95 at Centenario, the
Guys, play fair, please. Guys, play fair.
I was trying to get a balloon off because I was.
All right, but play fair.